People, welcome back to Politics Watch. This is Sir P. Now, today we're going to talk about a different type of kerosene. A type of kerosene where a lot of people don't talk about, or to be honest, enough people don't even know that it exists. I'd go even a step further. Enough people don't want to believe that it exists, especially their parents and relatives. I'm talking about the Uptown kerosene oil. This female is the ultimate snake on the grass. Now, unlike the kerosene oil from say Lauriston or Tredegar Park or Jones Avenue, who only gets access to the 87, maybe the 90, the Uptown kerosene, she gets access to the 116s, and she has the complete pick of the litter as to which octane she's going to get involved with. She can go 116, she can go 90, she can go 87. It's completely up to her, especially if she's very, very attractive. Now, we could start at 116. No? Remember the 116 video? Enough high society women, well-spoken, well-dressed, very well-educated, they are kerosene oils. They play the same rules as the garrison kerosene oil, but at a much bigger level. So she's not necessarily setting up nobody to lead them around one corner for sci-fi come with him up 100 times. See, she's either married to the 116 or she's the 116's mistress, right? And the 116 uses her to maybe carry out espionage on his fellow 116s to get information the Kerbach come cross, come give him. But let me just make it known from now. These type of kerosene oils, they're not very interesting. As I said, the level you're playing at, most Jamaicans can't relate. The type of kerosene, or the type of Uptown kerosene I'm going to be focusing on, is the one them will stray from their environment and find themselves in a bad man place. The ultimate snake on the grass. You see, these kerosenes, they usually come from the quote-unquote good family. Now, when Jamaican people say somebody come from a good family, 99 out of 100 times, what they mean is the family have resources, the family have material things. And then people judge that and say they come from a good family. What enough people don't realize is Uptown, and of course, I mean Uptown, I don't necessarily mean only Narbrook and Cherokee, and I mean any wealthy, you know, your typical wealthy family from background. These homes can be acidic too. Yes. These homes can be very toxic for children too. These children also grow up with all kind of problems. Money, as me say, is not the root of the issue. It's acidity. So, enough of these children, they go to the best schools, they get the best shoes and the best bags, and they can even hire a tutor. But the pity them and see some things in the house, they mash up their meds. A lot of these Uptown kerosene oils, they have daddy issues. But daddy is there. One if not read me. One if not read them, I say. Daddy is physically there, you know. But they have daddy issues. Because enough people that talk about is, in a lot of these high society homes, a lot of those wealthy businessmen, because them have so much upon them head, so much stress and them have to meet so much deadlines and them can't manage it, enough of them turn to the rum buckle, enough of them turn to the Diet Coke. And when them go home, them take it out upon them family. So now, look a girl grow up and turn woman, right? I know people are wonder why she a babe, so why is she lashing out like this? Why is she acting like that? She grew up in an amazing family. No, she didn't. Right? So now she find herself looking around, wondering, you know what? How can I punish daddy? See, it's a subconscious thing. None of them don't actually say this to themselves, you know. But subconsciously, they want to inflict pain and misery on them father. It's like revenge for what them used to go through when my picnic and see what daddy used to go on. So now, Abigail, or Isabel, or Leah, or Becky, you know, traditional Uptown names. Yes, Simple Simon, we know people all over the world can get the name there. But those are traditional uptown names. You know, your Maybelline. Now she's like 19 years old. Hot like fire. Daddy thinks she gonna start par with Matthew or Chad or Brandon or Carlton. Oh no, 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 no. No, 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 not Maybelline. Maybelline want daddy to suffer. Maybelline want daddy to stress out. Maybelline find herself over Lariston a link with sci-fi. Find herself on Klansman base. See, one day, Maybelline and her friend them did have one little house party up in Narbrook. And when she look around, and she see Chad, and she see Brandon, and she see Carlton, she no see nobody who get her pulse racing. She's thinking all of these guys are safe options. Daddy would love these guys. Daddy would want me to be with these guys. Daddy would be proud. She doesn't want any of that. Remember, she's acidic now. Good is bad, and bad is good. So she tell her friend them, say, listen, you know what we need to do right now? Like, OMG, we need to like go to like Pasa Pasa Wednesday. Yeah, come on, girl. And the rest of uptown girls them, Abigail and Isabel, you know, they're like, up, Pasa Pasa Wednesday, that's dangerous. Maybelline said, that's the point. Them jumping at them Kiara, you know, so daddy buy her a Kiara, she knows she turned 18. Find themselves on a Pasa Pasa Wednesday, find themselves on a Weddy Weddy Wednesday, find themselves on a Bossy Tuesday. When she look, she see one thugs in the corner. Place dark, all she can make out is that him have a spliff in him and a Guinness. And when she look, when the camera light shine on the ground, she spot him clocks. A win in the corner. The one that had the edges. She take time, screechy go over there. Now edges spot her right away, because remember edges not really used to girl look like this. Right? Edges I say, oh, that girl I get so close. She crack her one smile right away, edges pick up what I go on. You don't know. Get a youth confident. Edges running and jumping her ears right away. Lyrics work. The lyrics work. She tell her friend them to listen. I'm not coming back home with you tonight. You guys can leave me here. Take the car and go. She jump on the back of Aji's bike. When them pull out, she see 10 more bike. Be a Klansman. Be a Reverend. You know, Garrison, you go on a red when Tanya get a bike. Everybody have his 7 time in my life. Right? And the one look right where she ride through the streets. Remember, you know, Chad have one bike too, you know. But every time Chad ride, him put on him helmet, put on him leather jacket, put on him gloves, safety first. Hodges a riding bike, he not even have on a shirt. No shirt, no helmet, no protective gear. That make Maybelline get excited. She has said, yo, this dude is dangerous. Daddy is gonna be so pissed off if he sees me with him. So now, she end up on the block. But this is what you must understand about the uptown kerosene. It's all just a phase. It's just a phase because the uptown kerosene know one thing for certain. She knows that at any given time she can switch back to being an uptown girl and society will forgive and forget. Unlike the Garrison kerosene who is stuck in her position. See, the Garrison kerosene, when her 87 dead or whatever, in the matter, she's permanently scarred. That is sci-fi baby mother. That is crab woman. She can't shake it off. With the uptown kerosene, she can easily shake it off. So she's just having fun, right? She's just driven and attracted to the raw masculine energy. You see, this is what turn on the uptown kerosene. She don't want the money, you know. She don't want no money. She don't want no clothes. She have all of that. Daddy, she have all the money in the world. She have all the material things. This is what turns her on. You see, when Chad and her do the things, you know, the bedroom things, hear Chad to her. Isabel, We've been in this position for quite some time now. Would it bother you if you could possibly like turn around so I may penetrate you vociferously? Asocha talked to her. But Sci-Fi, the man that grab her by her long ear and say, "Hey girl, turn over and give her back us." Maybelline wet up. Maybelline start leak like a water commission pipe when she hear that, and I'm not talking about informing. This is what she wants, the danger, the adrenaline. Because all her life, Maybelline has been getting treated like a princess. Everywhere she go, people treat her like she's decent, like she's upstanding. You see, while the garrison kerosene wants to get treated like a princess because she get tired of treated badly, Maybelline is the opposite. She's tired of being treated like a princess and she won't get treated badly. That's what Chad don't realize. That's what Brandon doesn't realize. That's what Carlton doesn't realize. But I just realized though. J-Bad realized though. Bigger Crime realized. And them treat her accordingly. See, Carlton depend on the, if she tell Carlton she'll come somewhere at 3 o'clock and she late, Carlton, I pick up the phone. Darling, I'm just calling because I want to make sure you're safe because you said you were going to come here at 3 o'clock. And it's now 3:15 and you're not here, so I just want to make sure you're okay. Not Bigger Crime. If Bigger Crime to 301 pass and she not reach. Hey girl. Hey girl, where are they? You need me to tell us. Yo, hurry up now. Take some egg. Hey. Alright, watch me when you come. Hang up the phone. Maybelline start leak like a water commission pipe. I want people to understand the acidity has no address. Acidity has no address. That is what's really giving her the kicks. So she has killed two birds with one stone. She's getting pissed off daddy, right? So she can get the men, she can inflict the mental pain that she wants to inflict on him and her family. I'll show you. And she's also getting her kicks from the danger. You see, Chad have gone enough. But Chad gone a license gone. Isabel not turned on by a license gun. But when she go a Lariston and she go buck up on Scott Thomas and him reach on in bed and pull out the 4-5, Maybelline nipple him get erect because she knows say 4-5 can't license, so it must be illegal. And then Scott Thomas to her say, "Yo, listen, let me show you something, man. Can't remind her. Garrison, you love inform upon themselves, you know. When they meet a one hot girl and they want to brag, they make police think the whole operation, cause they make Karen go show her rich by the rifle for them like." Matilda said, "You know, let me show you something, man. Karen one corner when she look 2 AK and a M16. Brandon never show her that yet. I didn't think that she love. I didn't think they turn her on. But you're the conflict. You see the garrison kerosene, when she see the Uptown kerosene come on the block, she resents her. She resents the kerosene from Uptown, from Norbert, from Cherry Garden, because she knows the kerosene, that kerosene, she not really want Scott Thomas, she not really want Adjis, she wants the experience. And when she gets the experience, she gone right back Uptown and down the road. Guess who she's getting married to? Brandon. She not get married to Adjis, you know? Listen, Adjis can give her all the side shot, front shot him want. She will never get married to Adjis. You mad? It's a phase and she will snap out of it. She'll never get married to Scott Thomas. Never. But the garrison kerosene who's been putting in the work, who have washed Scott Thomas' bloody clothes all along, and Scott now show her no respect. Scott don't even ride her up on the back of the bike again. And all of a sudden, he might carry through this Uptown girl. The garrison kerosene resent her. She resent her. And you know what's the worst thing about the Uptown kerosene? Unlike the garrison kerosene, who one of the main benefits to why females turn kerosene is because there is a security side to it, a short-term security. It's not real, right? But in the short term, they have security, meaning say, upon the block them safe, because if Nevada Hodges a your man, if James Hines a your man, then you're safe in the short term. See, in the long term, it come back and bite them, because when the man them start worried Hodges or James Hines, if they can't catch Hodges, then you go wait she up on the pit of them. Right, so it's really an illusion, but in the short term, it appears to be safety. So at least the garrison kerosene can say, well, me the one smarty, if you protect me in a violent community, that's why me end up start David Hodges. But the uptown kerosene has no excuse. It's just one big game to her. And the uptown kerosene know, so even if them get pulled over by the police, she can tell the policeman who her father is and police and make she go on. She can tell the police, as a matter of fact, the uptown kerosene might even be a lawyer. She know the law herself, and she'll tell the policeman, say, excuse me, do you have a warrant for that? Because remember, you know, sci-fi know him rights. So when him saw him lawyer kerosene deal with certain things in front of the police, him rate her even more. Him rate her even more. But more on people to understand something. The uptown kerosene, she understands society and how it works. She understand that, listen, in the end, even though right now her Hodges she a roll with and she dep on Hodges bite back, and she love the fact that she can sneak away and go burn the chalice on the block, and you know the man then put the rifle in her hand, cause as some bad man said, they literally put the rifle in a woman hand. Then the no man from now, but she don't want to impress the woman, right? She gave a whole arm pan the bomber. And I say, boy, oh, this is what it feels like. And sci-fi decide, yeah man, the bomber this. He might incriminate himself. Yeah man, I wanna really go over Chediga Park with man. So, you know, I want to hear about Chediga Park. Yeah man, I really go over the man. Yeah, that one I really use. Right, that's the 87th day. But the kerosene, even though she get her time having fun, even though she mix and mingle, even though she get the experience and she said to herself, this is what it's like. In the back of her mind, she knows where she truly belongs. And that is on the arms of Chad. And at first, Chad is very happy to make her his wife. But guess what happened one day, no? Somebody touched Chad and tell him, say, yo, you know, say, your wife look kind of familiar still. Where she come from? Lariston? Chad said, Lariston? Maybelline is from Norbrook. What do you mean Lariston? Like, no way. My wife isn't from that slum. Somebody said, no man, I'm sure I see her Lariston already. Chad bring down God off of the cross, it can't be. Man said, no man, I see her up on the back of Hodges' bike, man. What you mean? I'm sure saw she. Chad said, you know what? Okay, I know nothing go so, but let me just inquire. Only if Chad go here say a real thing. She really was with Nevada Hodges. Between the ages of 19 and 23. So people start to tell him, say, I just care a guy in my yard. Of her upon the corner. She a bunch of this and all kind of things. She a hold the machine them. Chad gets furious. You know why Chad furious? Because in order for Chad even know what one of the strap them on her brassiere look like, he had to first declare his entire net worth, Promissar, an X6, and build two pool, one outside and one indoors. That is what Chad had to do to get Maybelline. All Nevada Hodges had was a bike and a clocks. So now Chad starts to wonder to himself, then hold on. Me didn't need all of this. What you give to Hodges, cause I'm clocks and him roll up pants foot and him RR bike, and you go tell me say me have to demonstrate say me can do this to for you for the next. Chad get wicked. Chad get mad. Chad tell him father say me want a divorce. Daddy, I can't be with this woman. I can't. How can I be with a woman who was with somebody like Nevada Hodges? Daddy, I can't. Daddy, we need a divorce. Father look on upon him and tell him, say, son, your mother, your precious mommy, where me married to, she did there with Bowlby. And look where we are now. Forgive and forget. Uptown full of kerosene oils. Don't make the accent fool you. Don't make the soft-spoken feminine vibes fool you. Don't make the degrees fool you. Right? The man them carry them on the block, same way like how them carry the inner city girls them. Them a sneak way, go burn chalice, a feel up the rifle them, all a load, learn how to load all magazine and all kind of things. The uptown kerosene is the ultimate snake on the grass. But she know why she can't do that. Because as I said earlier, society will always forgive and forget. Society will not hold her, hold it against her forever. She can just put on her dress, get her hair done, put on her heels, and walk into any function in Jamaica and get respect. And when people speak to her, they have no idea that this uptown girl take her father money and give it to 87, fin go buy a shot, fin go buy a new strap, fin go buy a new M16. Nobody have the slightest of clues. Oh yes, unlike the struggling Garrison Kerosene, the Uptown Kerosene can fund 87's criminal operations. She and another type, guess which type of kerosene also fund 87 criminal ops and responsible for enough people dead indirectly because of Shia Biden gun and their shot. Guess no? The foreign kerosene oil. Make me know if you want that video there. Patreon squad, big up on yourself. Please like, comment, and share the video. Bless.